today I'm going to read Goldie Rocks and the Three Bears by Corey Rosen-Schwartz and Beth Colton.
Once upon a rock and roll time, three bears in a band jammed with ease. The Papa Bear drummed, the Mama Bear strummed, and Baby Bear tickled the keys. But the band didn't have many fans yet, and Papa Bear figured out why. Though we all love to croon and can carry a tune, we can't hit the notes way up high. So they set out to find a soprano. Soon after they left, a girl knocked. "Is that porridge I smell? Gee, that would be swell." She checked and the house was unlocked. "A studio! Great balls of fire!" Amazed, Goldie raced through the door. She forgot about food and was now in the mood to hurry on in and explore. The Mama Bear's mic hit her elbow, and Pops reached the top of her head. But Babies was hiked to just where she liked. "I'll give it a whirl," Goldie said. She grabbed it and started performing. "Ooh, doobie-wop, dum-dee-dee-doo." She was singing quite well till she stumbled and fell, and the microphone stand broke in two. So Goldie said, "I'll try the headphones." But Mama Bear's pair was too tight. The Papas were loose. "Geez, these are no use." But Baby Bear's fit her just right. That tune was so catchy, thought Goldie. I'd love to be part of their band. The guitar was too twangy, the cymbals too clangy, the piano was perfectly grand. Exhausted from moving and grooving, she needed to catch a few Z's. "This day's been a doozy, I'm feeling quite snoozy." She dozed off on Baby Bear's keys. In the meantime, the bears had held tryouts, but no one had blown them away. The hare was too twitchy, the pigs were too pitchy, and Red was just simply okay. The family returned to their cottage, distressed from their lack of success. When they saw the inside, the Mama Bear cried, "Egads, what a terrible mess! Someone's been using my mic stand."
"Someone's been using mine too."
Then Baby Bear spoke, "Oh no, my stand broke." He started to sniffle, "Boo-hoo." Then Mama Bear looked at her headphones. "Oh, someone has tried my pair on."
"Mine too," Papa growled.
The parents both scowled as Baby Bear cried, "Mine are gone." Then Papa said, "Who played my drum set?" And Mama said, "Who plucked my strings?" "Well, who's in my chair?" asked the littlest bear. "She's drooling all over my things." They stared at the slumbering blonde girl, and Papa asked, "Who could she be?" He disrupted her dream. She awoke with a scream. The pitch was a perfect high C. The bears asked to hear a whole medley, once Goldie recovered from shock.
"Amazing," said Mom. Pop grinned, "You're the bomb."
And Baby cried, "Goldie can rock." Together, they wrote a new ditty. They practiced it into the night. And soon their new jingle became a hit single. Too hot, too cold, or just right. Their albums now top all the rock charts. A countrywide tour has been planned. The fans scream and shout they're crazy about Goldie Rocks and the Great Three Bear Band.